near where the breast was operated on. As well as the arm beat and the arm on the operative side. It is often worse when you move the shoulder on the affected side. And the post-mastectomy pain may also increase when pressure is applied to that area, that means tenderness. Post-mastectomy Down syndrome symptoms can be continuous or intermittent with pain occurring every day or only a few days a week. And the pain can also aggravate or worsen by shoulder strain and the whole household course and even simple stretching. What are the clinical investigations that everyone has that pain should go through? It includes, usually the patient comes to have a history with a burning, numbness, sudden pain, electric shock, hyperesthesia or paresthesia. Numbness is a symptom reported in women, status post-surgery for treatment of breast cancer. Chest wall pain, decreased range of motion of the shoulder and decreased shoulder and grip stretch. Sensory, regarding the clinical examination, sensory changes at the post-operative site, decreased range of motion of ABC lateral upper extremity and decreased shoulder stress. The diagnosis is made based or upon the through physical examination of the remaining breast, chest wall, axilla, and upper extremity. And a complete sensory and motor neurological examination may reveal abnormalities in the affected peripheral nerve distribution. What about the management measures for relieving the post-mastectomy pain syndrome? It includes pharmacological management, including tricyclic antidepressants. It has been shown to be effective in the treatment of neuropathy, fibromyalgia, chronic low back pain, and osteoarthritis. Also, the group of anticonvulsants, it's used since 1960 for neuropathic pain. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory groups, this is a very common group to treat that type of pain, and also opioid, may also be used to treat chronic post-mastectomy pain in cases where other medications are not effective. Topical medications, such as capsaicin, that is believed to block the pain triggers or pain receptors or depressive pain receptors and the pain from primary afferent neuron. Studies have not proven high efficacy, but can be trialed in patient refractory to other types of treatment. Also, lidocaine 5%, topical ointment, and compounding creams are commonly used. Also, injection of pectoralis major, serratus anterior, decrease, this is muscles associated with the site of surgery. It decreases neuroma and relieve the pain. Brain neural infiltration of T4 and T5, 2 mmixture of equal parts of 5% bivalvocine and 4 mg dexamethasone is also common injection for that type of pain. We have other non-pharmacological measures for relieving the pain, including specific non-pharmacological physical modalities are often used to augment the pain treatment plan, for example, rehabilitative treatments such as optimizing the range of motion, strength, endurance, neuromuscular control, and reduced instability and the pain associated with this use. Slowly increasing daily living level by starting with 12 minute walk per day. Performing daily stretching of the affected shoulder in hopes of regaining prior range of motion and for prevention of adhesive capsules. We are discussing the other non-pharmacological modalities to relieve the pain that includes transcutaneous using of transcutaneous electrical stimulation that deliver mild electrical stimulation to painful regions. 15 for few studies, however, have focused on the efficacy of TENS for patients with cancer pain. We can use therapeutic exercise and massage of motion and reducing muscle tension. Physical therapists with a specialty in management of chronic cancer pain often have skills to encourage such a patient to encourage exercise when they observe minimal progress. Randomized controlled trial also encouraging acupuncture versus a usual care showed decreased pain and improved range of motion in acute post-operative period after breast surgery. Also, psychological intervention is very important for that case. Attention to psychological issues, such as affective distress, coping, beliefs about the cancer, is an important aspect of pain treatment programs, and the cancer pain can be identified by psychological distress, especially mood, disturbance, depression, fear, anxiety, as shown by a number of studies. Psychological intervention include education about the cancer, and hypnosis, and imagery-based methods, and training in coping skills. Educational involvement is focused on helping the patient to understand the pain assessment and to overcome barriers to treatment for pain. Finally, nurses have a very important role through all these discussed strategies. Okay, through involvement in the rehabilitative program and the education program for that patient from the time of surgery or before the time of surgery up to patient discharge regarding the post-operative instruction. Thanks.